Angelina Jolie, Jessica Biel, Kerry Washington and Catherine Zeta-Jones dazzle at Golden Globes red carpet amid protest. Hollywood united in solidarity with victims of sexual harassment and assault by wearing black on the red carpet at the 75th Golden Globe Awards at the Beverly Hilton on Sunday. But that didn't mean the likes of Angelina Jolie, Jessica Biel, Kerry Washington and Catherine Zeta-Jones gave up the opportunity to shine as they left at the red carpet glamour, with Zeta-Jones, 48, telling the Daily Mail, "The dress code didn't say anything about not looking our best." The color black was chosen as a way for the movie and TV industry to make a statement against a pervasive culture of misconduct, brought to light by the downfall of shamed movie mogul Harvey Weinstein, as a galaxy of stars officially kicked off 2018 awards season at the high-profile event. Angelina, 42, wowed in a stunning black gown with feathered sleeves and a sheer neckline. The mother of six paired the classic frock with diamond jewelry and pink glossed lips. Meanwhile, Jessica and Kerry chose to flaunt their sculpted arms in strapless dresses. Kerry, who plays Olivia Pope on the TV show Scandal, flashed her pins in a ruched sequin number. Jessica arrived on the red carpet with her husband Justin Timberlake. The lovebirds both chose Dior pieces. The sinner actress, 35, posed up a storm in her pleated gown, which featured sheer elements as well as a bold velvet accent. Catherine, who chose a sheer black lace from Zuhair Mourad's Fall 2017 Couture Collection, said Daily Mail's Baz Bamidboy, stating, "The dress code didn't say anything about not looking our best." The star, 48, styled the revealing gown with emerald earrings, bright lipstick and curled locks. While Catherine chose a long-sleeved look, Kate Hudson donned a low-cut halter number with a chunky diamond necklace. The stunning actresses were not the only ladies rocking cleavage-bearing looks. Halle Berry, pregnant Eva Longoria and Margot Robbie also chose to put their busts on display for this year's Golden Globes. Margot Robbie, who stars in I, Tonya, chose a silver and black plunging gown by Gucci with Roger Vivier strappy heels. The Australian actress painted her pout red with her locks wavy and loose. Reese Witherspoon, who starred in and executively produced the hit show Big Little Lies, shined in her black one-shoulder gown. The 41-year-old chose a Zac Posen mermaid cut frock, adding a chunky bracelet and coordinating earrings. She styled her blonde hair sleek and deeply parted. Her co-star and co-executive producer, Nicole Kidman, went for a completely different look. The Australian actress arrived with husband Keith Urban in a high neck frock with textured sleeves and a see-through neckline. Kendall Jenner, the model and reality star, hit the carpet in her voluminous gown. The catwalker was a vision in the layered number. Dakota Johnson, who plays Anastasia Steele in the 50 Shades of Grey franchise, wore a sleek gown with silver details. Allison Williams, 29, was a vision in the ornately designed strapless gown, which featured burnt orange and silver elements and a textured skirt. The girls actress paired the eye-catching ensemble with chunky diamond choker, pulled back locks and minimal makeup. The Golden Globes have always been the less serious stop en route to the Academy Awards. But thanks to the Me Too movement, Hollywood's annual booze up took on the tenor of a protest rally on Sunday night. And that couldn't have been clearer than when looking at the red carpet, with the majority of female guests ditching the usual array of bright shimmering dresses in favor of solemn black. The lack of other colors was chosen as a simple way to show solidarity with the victims of sexual harassment and assault. It proved the most prominent and public display yet for the movement that has swept through Hollywood, leaving a trail of disgraced men in its wake. It was an uncharacteristically serious moment for the Globes, which have traditionally been a celebration, a good time before the sober Oscars. But they have had their political high points as well, like last year's speech by Meryl Streep, the Cecil B. DeMille recipient for Lifetime Achievement. She spoke forcefully against then-President-elect Donald Trump, who the next morning responded that Streep was overrated. However, Mara Tatnett, the Hollywood Foreign Press Association president, stood out in her red, silver and white gown, she added a Time's Up pin. Actress Blanca Blanco also chose a bold crimson frock for this year's Golden Globes. She flashed her cleavage as well as her legs in the revealing number. This year's recipient is Oprah Winfrey, who earlier called the fallout following the allegations against Harvey Weinstein a watershed moment for women. Winfrey is among the hundreds of women in the entertainment industry who have banded together to form Time's Up, an initiative to advocate for gender equality among studio and talent agency executives. It has also created a $14 million legal fund for victims of sexual harassment. Time's Up, whose members include many Globes attendees, including Reese Witherspoon, Gal Gadot and Emma Stone, unveiled itself Monday with full-page newspaper ads. And there's fodder for its cause on display at the Globes itself. Five Men will compete for Best Director tonight despite several potential nominees in Greta Gerwig, Lady Bird, Deary's Mudbound and Patty Jenkins' Wonder Woman. The category will be much watched when Oscar nominations are announced January 23. Indeed, the Globes are starting to see some of the same criticisms on diversity that have trailed the Academy Awards in recent years. But unlike the Academy of Motion Pictures Arts and Sciences, which has revamped its 6,000-plus membership to make its ranks more inclusive, the same pressure hasn't been applied on the Hollywood Foreign Press Association, an organization of about 90 largely unknown foreign journalists. But the HFPA's works have drawn increased scrutiny, including this year's oversight of one of 2017's most acclaimed comedies, Kumail Nanjiani and Emily Gordon's interracial rom-com The Big Sick. Also snubbed was Girls Trip breakout star Tiffany Haddish. Her co-star Jada Pinkett Smith last month took HFPA members to task for not taking Girls Trip seriously for its awards. And then there's the choice to slot in Jordan Peele's Get Out as a comedy, for the film and star Daniel Kaluuya. That provoked the Globe's largest backlash, and helped make Get Out the most tweeted about nominee in the 2 weeks after nominations were announced in December, Twitter said Thursday. Get Out is one of the favorites in the mix on Sunday, along with Guillermo del Toro's The Shape of Water, which led all films with 7 nods. Close behind is Steven Spielberg's The Post and Martin McDonagh's Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri, both with 6 nominations. One wild card is Ridley Scott's J. Paul Getty drama All the Money in the World, which landed 3 nominations, including one for Christopher Plummer. His performance was inserted at the last minute to replace Kevin Spacey, who has been accused of sexual misconduct by several men. The top TV contenders are female-led dramas, HBO's Big Little Lies, which Witherspoon stars in and produced, and the FX anthology series Feud, Bette and Joan,